I reckon liberals would be willing to bring that red pencil back to grade my paper if I were to fill out this survey. They'd be grading while ripping a hole in the paper with their extra sharpened red pencil.
I think what happened. Propaganda.
Next question. Free enterprise benefits the rich at the expense of the poor. Yes or no? You know you better answer yes on this one, or you're just a little capitalist pig. The question is designed to make conservatives look like aristocratic anarchists. Again, we're not opposed to regulation. Our interpretation and application of regulations is just conservative, which benefits the rich and the hopefully temporarily poor, and guards a better environment for the poor to work their way out of poverty. Now, this is why this premise of liberals is so wrong. It is very hard for rich people to make money off of people who don't have any. Businesses want people to have money. They want you to have jobs so you can make money. Then take that money and spend it so they can make more money. And invest that money into more jobs so more people can make money. And then spend it so the entrepreneur can make more money. The entrepreneur can't just rely on millionaires to buy their products. There's a lot more people in America making a five-figure income who need to buy things too. And the business person wants to make things affordable to them. Economy 101, if you want to sell more products and make more money, charge less. But even that don't mean squat if people are too poor to buy your products. The rich wants the poor to make money and make it out of poverty. And the ones standing in the way of that are liberal Democrats who negatively affect the hiring power of people because Democrats are dependent on victims for their voter stock. By the way, you'll notice this questionnaire is liberal or conservative. Not Democrat or Republican, because the Democrat Party is trying to throw off their rotten sin again. I told you, that's what they do. They're doing it right in front of you. Next question. Government should guarantee medical care for all citizens, yes or no? The questionnaire is pointless if you've read the Constitution, and of course, the people who make this test just want you to answer yes, like a good prospective liberal, without consideration of what the Constitution says. Government's job is to protect us, not provide for us. The people are duped by the Affordable Care Act, which in itself is a lie. Take advertisements like Covered California that tell you if you can't afford the health care coverage the government is forcing you to buy, then you can get financial assistance. If the government is making health care so affordable, why would people need financial assistance to buy it? And where does the money for this financial assistance come from? The people. The people are being forced to give financial assistance to pay for someone else's coverage that they have to buy and they have to choose from the roster of government selection. And you liberals try to sell us on the idea that this isn't socialized healthcare, even though you think socialized healthcare is the better model. After all, we should be like Europe. Yet on the other hand, a lot of these same liberals who think that want an exemption. Hey, can I let y'all in on a little secret? It's socialized healthcare. Next question. The Supreme Court should reverse its decision to legalize abortions in order to protect the right to life for the fetus. Yes or no? Here's an easy way to find out who's who, ain't it? Now, I notice with all these questions, they use the term government. The government should do this or the government should do that. But out of 18 questions that imply what the government should or should not do, this question is the only one that says the Supreme Court. I reckon it's because liberals want you to believe that the Supreme Court is the only branch that has the power concerning this issue. I think it's sad that we haven't had a president with enough meat and potatoes to say, hold up, judicial branch, you don't have the final say on this. I'm the chief law enforcement officer of the United States, and the supreme law of the land written in the Constitution says no person shall be deprived of their life without due process of law. So I'm telling you that you have broken the law. You have violated the Constitution, and that you ruled to make laws that protect people who want to deprive persons of life without due process, and did so by ruling against the child's personhood. Y'all really think that power alone should belong to the Supreme Court? Let me ask it to you like this. You think all that power should have belonged to the Supreme Court in deciding that blacks aren't persons and do not qualify for the same protections of the Constitution? Lincoln, the Republican, didn't think the Supreme Court should have either. And he remembered that he was the chief law enforcement officer of the United States and put the boots to those who broke the law concerning the depriving of liberty. But Lincoln was a war criminal who violated the rights of shut up. Lincoln said straight up, those who deny freedom to others deserve it not for themselves, and under a just God cannot long retain it. In other words, I reckon Lincoln was saying, if you deprive others of their rights, then I'll ignore yours. Next question in the next donation. Can I let y'all in on a little secret? It's socialized healthcare.